good evening, everybody. How you guys doing? And our name is Dishwala, and we're from Santa Barbara, California. Very happy to be here at your beautiful school.
I'm on my way. Why did you guys decide to refer to God as a woman in the song Counting Blue Cars?
I wanted to write something that actually meant something, you know, not like a Bush lyric that's like totally cryptic and vague. So it's just interesting to see a big reaction out of something, even though that was kind of the intention, was to try to mean something. So, I mean, that's cool. I mean, definitely we were very successful from that perspective.
Yeah, none of us actually expected that people would freak out as much as they did, you know, based on one word. Yeah, that's really all what it's all about, is one word.
My point of view is that it's just that. It doesn't really matter. The fact we put a label on something and are so adamant about it having to be that way is what's ridiculous to me. And to get a rise out of people where people get upset about it, it's exactly what I'm talking about. It's like, that's my point. You're not very open-minded. We need to be more open-minded.
I mean, if anything, that's great that the media made a big deal out of it. You know, it's great for publicity, and it's, you know, if you get a rise out of people somehow, fine.
Yeah. We try to make people think about certain issues or whatever, and they tend to be real socially oriented ones. I mean, because as far as like a lot of stuff that we discuss, we don't really tend to agree on everything. In fact, there's a lot of things we don't agree on. Surprise. But I mean, that's, you know, that's part of the dynamic.
Like, what issues you guys disagree on?
Actually, just about everything.
Just about everything, truthfully.
It's amazing that we can actually stand in the same room together.
Sometimes just for the sake of disagreeing, actually.
Oh, You guys have been on the road for about 2 years now, is that right?
Yeah.
Over the course of those 2 years, y'all went from a fairly unknown band to a popular one. Did things happen overnight? How did you, were you able to identify a change during the tour?
It was really incremental. I mean, super baby steps. You know, we get added to one station and then another, and then we get a cool show here, and just, it was lots of little fires that we were setting around the country, and in this case, it worked out.
It's really hard to gauge that something is really changing that dramatically. I mean, if I look back now, it's 2 years ago, yeah, I can see a difference, but being in it, involved in it at the time, it's like, you're not aware of what's going on. It's like they hand you, like, some plaque, and you're all, you know, why? What's this? It's weird. You know, all I was doing is thinking about what Sega game I'm going to play in the back of the bus that day.
So what's life like on the bus and out on tour?
It's a little like camping, except with a microwave. You can, like, be in the middle of any city in the nastiest part of town, you walk around your tour bus and you're in your safe zone. So, it definitely rules compared to a band. So,
anything to add, gentlemen? I don't have much to say.
I definitely expected Spinal Tap. That was like my only touring film I had ever seen, so I took it as what really happens.
That is when your life starts to turn into that movie after you tour long enough. And you start to, like, get upset about the finger sandwiches and the, you know what I mean? I'm a professional. And you go, whoa, what an asshole, you know? That's the Spinal Tap. I don't know. Don't you think?
We got lost at a theater trying to find the stage one night.
We ask for a lot more vegetables now than we used to. We don't eat them. But we ask for more of them. And we get more of them.
Bobby the cool chair. Doing all our children how to do it right. And it doesn't get much worse than that. Why the need to run inside our children?